Alright guys, hello and welcome to the next educational series. In this one we're going to be doing Monkey King, a hero that is very popular in Southeast Asia and the hero that was requested from the Gas Mobile community. So I hope you guys will enjoy this video. Now, the difference between this one and my previous ones is that this one is actually recorded live streamed. And normally I don't do that anymore because obviously people ghost and stuff, but sadly YouTube has been having a lot of issues lately, which has forced me to record this on live because I'm really delayed. It's Thursday, it's 2 p.m. And the video is supposed to be uploaded tomorrow, so I had to actually do it on stream and because of YouTube screwing up with their uploads. Anyway, it should be hopefully ready on time anyway, and should be good. So let's go through his abilities really fast. I'll check it out, PS. One second, let me write it down. Alright, so first of all, we got Elusive Dash. Dash forward dealing 15, 20, 25, 30 plus your attack damage at impact. This is actually interesting because this was a change in a recent patch that actually buffed Monkey King's Q to the way it used to be. The way Monkey King used to be was 10, 20, 30, 40, I believe, or 20. No, it was 20. 20, 30, 40, 50 on his Q before he got that nerfed. So they've restored a little bit of the power on Q. It's still only a 1-point wonder, so you still want to max out your W and your E. But it's a little bit better now than before. So Q will be the first ability that will put a point in. And then second of all, we got Heavenly Vault. Basically, you vault over a target, a ward. You can actually, yes, do it on a ward, which is kind of awesome. So if you aren't aware of that, you can actually vault on wards, buildings, and all of that jazz. So that's pretty awesome.
Can you spawn him?
Oh my god, give me a second here. I thought I was playing Melee Hero mid, but apparently not.
I prefer to talk.
So we will be maxing out our Heavenly Vault, that is our main damage ability, and after that we're gonna max out our One Jin Slam. Oh crap. I really want a Buckler versus a Hagman, like he's just gonna haunt me and harass me. Yeah, this is really bad. Why did they put Hag mid? Look at their lineup, man. Anyway, so after Heavenly Vault, we got One Jin Slam. Slam the ground in front of you, raising a small rock. After a short delay, it will have a secondary impact. So basically, it has one impact, then after a short delay, you have a second impact. So this is what you're going to be using in the Monkey King combo. As I'm sure you're aware, there is a combo with Monkey King that makes you do the maximum damage possible. And there are two ways of doing this combo. Hopefully, I'll be able to show you both ways of doing the combo. Anyway, I'm going to be harassing him here. Oh, just kidding. He dodged that. Well, he just blinked. Do you have anything?
Is that a fucking hack?
Yes, that's a hack.
I can't see what
he does not blink for another 4 seconds. 4, 3, we don't have enough. My vault is missing 5 mana.
No,
anyway, and then last but not least, we got Flying Nimbus. When you're not taking damage, you get on top of a cloud, and you get an increased movement speed. So that basically allows you to roam very, very easily. Besides that, it also lowers your cooldown by 0.5, 1, and 1.5 seconds. So that's Monkey King. It's a very fun, very mobile, and very fast hero. And it was, of course, Mika's favorite hero, my old teammate. And he played it yesterday, actually, when I teamed with him. And yeah. So let's get back into the game, shall we?
Double damage.
Alright. I can take it after bottle. Yeah, but I need my bottle first. Anyway, when you're playing against a hero like Hag that doesn't have too much armor in the start, you can actually kill her very early if she messes up. So you want to play very, very aggressively. Normally you would have a buckler against a ranged hero, especially something like a Hag, but as I said, she kind of fooled me. Okay, going for it now. She kind of fooled me there, so I missed out on it. Anyway, so there are two combos, as I said. One of the combos allows you to land on top of the hero. The other one guarantees that you get everything off. And basically what you do is that you QE, WWQ, or you QE, WQW. I hope you follow there. So there's QE, WWQ, or QE, WQW. I'm coming. So there are two combos. One of them allows you to... Put yourself behind them, and one allows you to be on top of them. And they're good in different scenarios, which I hopefully can show you here in the game. But we'll see. Is this educational? Yeah, sadly, I had to do my educational this time on stream. So that's why it's on stream. Usually it's off stream, and it's usually quiet, so it doesn't... So you guys don't know what's coming, you know? So it's like a oh, Slap's it's Friday. Slap's gonna release an educational. What hero is it? And then I'll, yeah, then you'll see it, obviously. But this time we had to, sadly, like I said, do it on stream. Let's see if I can bait him to go on me here with the help pot. Can almost kill him here. There we go.
You don't need bottom?
Yeah, I need a rune, yeah.
I got the top one. I got the top one.
Okay, I'll take bottom. Okay, okay. Running bottom lane. So yeah, two combos. I will do it very slowly now. So QEWWQ or QEWQW. I will hopefully be able to show you the combos, as I've said now a couple times. Let me just run bottom here. Gonna try and gank. Obviously, I did not do the combo here mid. I leapt on top of him to get closer to him and then just try and get as much damage off as possible. That was a different kind of scenario. Let's go. Go stun. Nice. I actually forgot to say that. Of course, since you can vault on wards, you can vault on buildings, you can of course vault in your one Jin Slam like I just did. All I needed to do there was vault on him, so I E'd, and then I vaulted on it, landed on top, and did enough damage for us to kill him. Why aren't you going to Vegas? What the fuck are you on about? You and your Vegas. I'm not going to Vegas. Hopefully once in my life I will go to Vegas, or more than once. But I have no plans on going to Vegas anytime soon. Alright, let's see if we can do a combo here. Illusion. Let's see if he walks up. Yeah, this is usually the skill build you want to do. You might want to pick up a level of ultimate at level 8, but not really earlier than that. This is the best way to do it. Usually allows you to kill most heroes in a combo. Really depends on it. But let's see if we can get a combo here on Hag if she ever walks up. Gonna pick up a thingy for Ghost Marches as well. Let's see here. We might actually get him here. No! Fuck. As you saw right there, sadly she was able to blink just before I got the combo off. And that's the problem. Like, when you're playing heroes like blink heroes, if you do it perfectly timed, you can actually stop them from blinking completely. But sadly, I was a little bit too late there and not able to get the combo off.
Any level.
Slapped, is Mickey back in Han? No. Mickey was just, he saw the patch, he wanted to try it out, so he teamed up with me a little bit yesterday. Alright. Let's keep going. But yeah, as you saw right there, if I was able to get the combo off before she blinked, I would have actually killed her from full life. So your combo does a lot of damage. The thing about the combo is, like, the point of it is that you want to be drag them into your 1G and slam twice. So you want to QE to do the initial damage from your E, and then you want to vault them back into it, so they always take the double... Well, the double activation of your E, I should say. So that's why you want to make a combo.
We can kill this guy, maybe?
Alright, let me see if I can do it again. So here you go. As you saw right there, I did the combo where I do Q last. So basically, QEWWQ. And that allowed me to instantly land on top of him after finishing off the combo. So I'm sure if you guys paid attention to that, you saw that I did the exact combo there that is really good. And if he stays in his lane now, I can actually kill him with the exact same combo that I just did. Yep. So that was a perfect combo right there.
Beware.
I shot my bowl thing though.
Nice ship, bro.
Yeah, okay, I'm not gonna fall in there.
Do you have any contact with Testy? No, I don't. How does Mickey feel about the patch? Well, yeah, he had fun yesterday. I'm not sure what he thinks about the patch in total, but yesterday he had fun at least.
Here's the thing, can we go?
Alright, so let's see if we can do the other combo. If you want to know, Mickey usually uses the one where you queue in the middle. I usually use the combo where... I'll take top, I guess. No, you took... I'll take top. Usually I do the combo that I just did, where you do queue last and you blink into them. But Mickey does the other one more often. He usually calls me a retard for using this one, so... You know, it's... I guess it's personal preference, and like I said, it's also different in different situations, whether or not it's better or worse. But I generally just do the combo that I just did. I find that to be the most effective. Let's dive top. Nope. Oh. Let's go, bro.
I'm very low, and Haggis is far.
Don't even have to blink there.
Nice mid, top.
we don't have enough to kill him, I guess. Well, you don't have ulti, right? Oh, fuck me.
Oh, shit.
I did not see that blacksmith coming.
Coming.
Did I see him on my minimap? I didn't, right?
I'm going back.
No, I didn't. There's no way. After you pick up these items, you could, well, normally power supply depends. If you're playing against a lot of spells, like the Legion lineup, you want to get a power supply. Otherwise, a Grave Locket is totally fine. Getting that little bit of tiny extra bit of stats early game helps Monkey King out a lot. So a Grave Locket, a power supply, something like that is very good to have. After that, you want to look into items like Shroud, Hellflower, Bulwark, and items like that. Normally, I prefer the Hellflower build. I think it's very strong, gives you permanent mana, gives you a little bit of damage, and gives you the 4.5 second silence to pretty much kill any hero in the game. So I personally like Hellflower, and the combo of Shroud plus Hellflower is very, very strong. Let's see if we can get this game.
Oh,
you're done. Thanks, bro. So the combo of Shroud plus Hellflower is usually a kill, and I kind of like that combo. So if you can pick up an early Shroud Hellflower, that's pretty strong. Against their lineup, I'm gonna need to pick up a Shrunken Head, like no matter what. So no matter what I want to do this game, eventually I need a Shrunken. Can we get this? I don't think they have a ward here. Might be a kill. See, I did the combo perfectly there again, with finishing off with the Q to blink in towards the hero. And that's the combo, once again, that I personally prefer over the other one. Because I like the way that you just land on top of them, and it just, personally to me, is better. I will show you the other combo in a second. Do it on next hero. Sorry, was there a subscription I missed? Salvagers, thank you for 4 months of subbing, bro. Sorry for missing it. My bot is broken at the moment, so I can't see donations and subs. It doesn't make a sound, and it doesn't pop up in the chat.
Really?
I'm running.
And he's up here.
Help. Let's keep chasing, keep chasing.
He should be hex.
I'm coming.
Oh, fuck. I'm good. Right, we're gonna go with Shroud here first, because this is a very active game and I want to be as active as possible and get a lot of kills. So I feel like the Shroud first will allow me to just keep on getting picks. The problem with going Shroud first is that you will have a very big mana issue, so you'll basically use your Shroud, find a kill, and then you can't do anything until you go back to base or region, which is what your bottle is for. So we're gonna make sure that we'll get full use of this. I'm on my way. I can almost blink in a tower, give me a second. Okay, I'm going now. Nice shit, bro. So as you can see, I'm 4-2 and 4 now, been able to set up a lot of kills, and most of my kills have been to either using combos or using buildings to initiate. So as you can see, it's a very big part of who Monkey King is. Let's see if we can get a combo here on this fucker. Probably not. Ah, can't even reach him. Oh, got him to half HP at least. Bottom or top rune, let's gamble, go bottom rune. He's walking towards bottom rune, so should be able to. Yeah, he's... Okay. I'm gonna have to just go for this. I'm good. We can turn. We can turn. I'm regening up.
I'm here.
Okay, let's go, let's go. Just have to pretend I was going back to base. Yeah, that was a really bad combo, the one I did right there. Alright, let's go. I have dust for Nomad. Let's go, let's go, let's go. I'm waiting, I'm waiting. Ah. Oh, really good, man. Really good. Alright, let's get the tower. I haven't been able to do the other combo yet. Well, I kind of unintentionally did it on Hag there before, because I queued before the last W, but... Yeah. Like, Mika's argument for using the combo he does is that the way he does the combo is that he always puts them behind him, you know? So if he initiates with the combo, they will be behind him. So with the last W he does, he pushes them back, while I push myself on top of them. So I like being on top... I like being on top and auto-attacking, while he likes to push them back towards his team, so... My point here is that Mika's combo, or the one he does mostly, is better when you want to push them towards your team, while my combo is better for solo pickoffs. Alright. Let's kill some stacks. That's so cool to know you can jump on words. Yes, you can. It's pretty awesome. Hey! I got him in 2 seconds otherwise. Nah, I'm not even gonna use it. I don't have to. I'm just gonna use it. Waste of time. Alright, let me see if we can pick up our shroud. There we go. And a teepee. Did they nerf the price on... They buffed the price. They did. It's 3.2. Wasn't it 3.3? Or am I being really stupid? Wasn't Shroud's recipe 1300?
I got ulti mid.
I think I'm being stupid. Anyway, so Hellflower into Shrunken will be our next two items here. That's a very, very strong item combination. Jinjiro is also amazing in Monkey King, eventually. But I definitely want to get my Hellflower here. It's really good against their heroes, good against heroes with blinks as well, of course. Good at locking down targets and killing them within 4.5 seconds. Because Monkey has so much burst that with a Hellflower you can pretty much kill any hero. Also, guys, don't forget to check out Gas Mobile on the App Store if you're from Southeast Asia. You can check that down in the description, where you can play sort of a Plinko wheel where you can win avatars, announcers, and other cool stuff. So if you're watching this video and you want to win cool hunt prizes, check out the description below.
Guys, it's a free kill. You're all in this.
Slap plus testy equals epic stream. I don't really think so, but... I got your back, Bubble T's
left. CP top, and then where else, CP?
Oh, fuck. Well, I just goofed.
I can see me in some.
One of your structures is under attack. They nerfed steam staff? Oh, right. No, wait, what? Oh, so they nerfed steam staff, so they... So they what? They buffed the recipe cost to make up for it? Or what? Interesting. Yeah, I remember reading it, maybe. Mm-hmm. Yeah, let me just get the rune. Oh, it's the App Store thing. It's an application for Southeast Asian players. They have a Hon application called Gas Mobile. The shirt, my friend.
Are we dying?
Sell out, boys. Yep. Kill stealing. Yes. Also, guys, of course, as I've mentioned before, if you do enjoy my videos, don't forget to leave a like on them. It helps my videos out a lot, way more than you probably think. So if you do like it, don't forget to drop a like below, like I always say in my educationals. If this does end up being on YouTube, which it hopefully will be. Let's see if we can get a kill here in the mid lane, pick up our first Arcana. As for other items this game, Demonic is also pretty good. They do have quite a bit of physical damage, like not an amazing amount of physical damage, but quite a bit regardless. So it might be worth picking up a Demonic eventually. But we do want to finish our Hellflower Shrunken first regardless. So we're going to pick up our first Arcana here. Sadly, they just nerfed Arcana, so they're not as good as they used to be. They're still really good, but... Oh, fuck. Well, I got silence. And that Pearl to just fuck me. Can we go back in? Legendary! One of your structures is under attack. I have two spells, I think, or one and a half. Let's use a couple more spells. Back. Well, we have King Cloud ult. No, we don't. Okay, just back. Yeah, just back. Fuck it. It's not Terrace Arcana. Kill stealing, yes. Yes. Love my kill stealing. You either die a pro player or live long enough to see yourself become a sellout. Damn. See, this is why I don't do this on stream. Alright, well, the rune was at the bottom. So, real one is top. Perfect. As you can see now, when you pick up your first Arcana and you have your Shroud, you already do so much damage that you can pretty much instantly kill creep waves, as well as, what the hell? Who took that? Oh, you son of a bitch. You can almost instantly kill creep waves as well as jungle camps, so you farm very, very fast. It is noted, however, that you do not instantly kill creep waves. You almost do. I think it's when you hit two Arcanas that you instantly kill them with QE. I don't actually remember. I haven't played Monkey King in quite a bit of time. But I think it's when you have two Arcanas that you start instantly killing creep waves. So you're a very, very fast split pusher. Okay. Did I miss anything in chat? Might as well read it now. Anyway, as someone actually pointed out in the chat right now, the first step of learning Monkey King is not using the combos. That is actually a very good tip, because the combos are very hard to pull off, and if you just learn how to effectively use your QE into sometimes vaulting, that's really all you need to be a good good Monkey King player. So I actually like that you mentioned that, chat. That don't worry too much if you can't get the combos off. They're kind of hard to do sometimes, and they need to be very fastly made. So, like, don't focus too much on it, man. Like, if you can't pull off the combos, it's totally fine. And just focus on being good in lane, knowing your limits, and how aggressive this hero can be. Because this hero can actually kill most heroes at level 3 or 4 quite effectively. That doesn't have a lot of HP, because it does a lot of bursts. Okay, it is your 1 Arcana now with the buff to Q. Alright, so since they buffed Q, it's now with your first Arcana. So if you have Shroud and 1 Arcana, you instantly kill creep waves with that.
I think we should try.
Before the buff to your Q, you weren't able to instantly kill creep waves by 1 Arcana. I'm 90% sure of that. I might be wrong, but I'm 90% sure that you needed 2 Arcanas. But yeah, let's test the next creep wave just to make sure I didn't do extra damage there or something. Let's see here. Yeah, okay. Yeah, it's 1 Arcana now. Good to know. Because of the buff to Q. Alright, so we are almost 500 GPM here. Gonna pick up our second Arcana. Won't send that out yet, of course. I'm just gonna go. We can get top tower, I guess. Right, there we go. So when you get that Hellflower, your mana issues are completely gone. As I said, you gotta be a little bit careful. I need that top rune.
Here.
Yeah, well, I kinda needed that top rune, Bray.
I don't have my ultimate yet. 10 seconds.
He just placed a red ward, we won't get him. Well, it could go, I guess. Oh, I actually dodged that. What a boss. I don't want to vault yet. I'm gonna save my. Oh, fuck. Well, I'm dead. Manning up. God damn it. Let's see. Is there anything I haven't covered about Monkey King? I said that Jinjiro's good, Hellflower's good. Demonic is decent if you're facing physical damage. Okay, so what items do you want to go for if you're not facing physical damage? Like, Wingbow is very good. Demonic's good. Like, actually, honestly, these four items here, minus the Nullstone, are all very good items on Monkey King. Nullstone, in my opinion, is not worth it on Monkey King. You don't want to buy it. But the build of Shroud and Hellflower is almost viable every game. And I think it's a great way of building him. And the Shroud allows you to do, because you're so fast with your ulti, right? So you can just max movement speed, move around the map, find pickoffs, and with the Hellflower, kill any hero in the game. So that's why I think it's so strong, and why it's one of my favorite builds. And then the Shrunken, of course, is only if they have a lot of stuns or a lot of mana damage, like the Legion team does, removing Bloodhunter Silence. Shrunken is a very good item this game, which is why I'm going to pick it up. But otherwise, finishing Genjiro, Wingbow's good, Demonic, Shieldbreaker. And if you go very, very late game, and you have, let's say, Ghost Marchers, let's say you have 5 of these items, Ghost Marchers plus 4 minus Nullstone, I guess you could go Rift Shards, Savage Mace. Just some kind of straight-up damage item, really. This hero is just, like, all about quick initiation burst, reset, quick initiation burst, reset. You go in, you go out, you go in, you go out, and you're very fast, and you have very big escape abilities because of your escape with E and W. So, yeah. Portal Key. I personally don't like Portal Key in Monkey King. I know that Mickey buys it every now and then, but Monkey King is already a very skill-based hero, and having a Portal Key to make your combos even harder, I don't recommend it. I would say for very good Monkey King players, like Mickey, sure, you can go Portal Key, but otherwise you should probably stay away from it. Alright, let me see. If I don't do the other combo this game, I'll just do it in practice mode for you guys before we end this video. We'll see if we can get the other combo done. So I got my Hellflower here in a second, almost 500 GPM. Normally I would probably be a little bit higher, I guess. You want to be around 500-600 with Monkey King because he farms very fast. Let's try and kill this hag. She's going to blink back, isn't she? Are you TPing out? They might have wards top. I think she's TPing out. Yeah, she's TPing out. God damn it. We'll stay just here in case she so shows, but I'm pretty sure she TPed. Yeah, she did. Oh god, no, I'm not ready to die again. Are you fucking serious right now? Okay. How do you like the cleaver build?
Well, it's quite nice that you can stack up the green ones, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's really good. Too easy. What about reworked Dawnbringer? It means your spells use plenty of mana, you can benefit from your auto attacks. No. The Dawnbringer is not a good item on Monkey King, in my opinion. I didn't like Dawnbringer before the changes either, so... I guess I'm just not a Dawnbringer fan in general on this hero. Did I actually hit that? I did. Son of a bitch, man. Go, 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 go! Easy game. There we go.
Nope.
Yeah, but he's very fun to play, right?
Yeah,
I personally think he's very fun to play. Alright. We do get a kill with Valkyrie. Good stuff. Alright.
And just a lore behind him is so fucking hilarious.
Alright, so we got our Hellfire now, so we can kill any hero on their team solo 1v1. So let's go and find some pickoffs. Sadly, I've died 4 times this game. Felt a little bit more than I usually do. But it is a very active hero after all, and you will be in a lot of shitty situations. The good thing about Monkey King, as I explained, is that you can escape extremely easily, unless you're playing a Bloodhunter who has a silence and an ulti that completely screws you over. So, Bloodhunter is obviously a good hero against Monkey King because you can't get out. But then again, there are a lot of heroes who are like that, so you can't say it's Bloodhunter alone. But Bloodhunter kind of screws your aggressive playstyle. I come back and it's Valkyrie. Yeah, I was controlling him while he was disconnected. Alright, 5 heroes, and they're all missing on the map. This is probably one of those plays that are gonna get me killed, but let's find out. It's probably a bait. It's very much a bait. Oh, crap. I cannot really save you, bro. Am I gonna kill myself now? Oh, he ulted you. Thank God he ulted someone else.
Yeah, okay.
I'm gonna try an arrow, wait. Holy shit, I'm good with this hero. Valkyrie OP, man. Nice shit, boys. Keep going, keep going. Oh, what? Where did he go? Didn't I just see him?
By the way, do you think Frostburn is better than Frostwall Skull? Considering they remade Frostwall Skull to have Frostwall Blade effect and it's cheaper and whatnot.
No, I think you can go Frostburn into Frostwall Shios if you want to. Like, your illusions work as well on your E. But you can go Frostwall if you want. But I personally think Frostburn into another item is better. Like, what the hell did I do yesterday? You can go Frostburn, Shrunken, Rift Shards, like... Doesn't really matter, I guess. Yeah, Arclight Crown is decent. No, I've done so many arrows without this game, man. OP. Yeah, Madman with Staff, dude. So fucking broken.
Yes, and you know, with Cleaver, the gas splits as well.
Yeah, it's really stupid.
It's insane, like, it's OP.
Alright, let's finish our Shrunken here, we're not gonna finish it, but we're gonna be halfway to finish it. Looks like we're gonna have to finish this game 4v5, so this might be a good game. Yeah. Valkyrie is sadly gonna be disconnected in a second. You pick up his Soul Trap, Solstice, when he gets disconnected. Let's Valkult before he disappears so we can at least use that. I'll arrow bottom for vision in a second. Okay, arrowing easy camp, and I'm gonna scout bottom myself. There might be 3 or 4 heroes top by the looks of it. They might be baiting top again. I'm not sure why they're baiting. We're not falling for it. We haven't fallen for it a single time. Yeah, they're all 5 top. All 5 top.
Can we get Tong then?
We could.
Jesus, all the money!
DD as well, we can get Tong, yeah.
Okay. When the party's over.
By the way, my stupid hex works on Kong as well, right?
La di da di da.
I can comment a bit. I have my ultimate.
Hey, go, 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 go! Really nice, bro. That bait actually ended up working perfectly. I can catch him. Okay. You just killed me, you bitch.
Oh my god, my sheep. He ulted my sheep.
Oh God damn it, man. Ah, they just killed me. RIP. Alright, so I think we covered items, we covered the hero, we covered combo. Is there anything else you guys want to learn about Monkey King for those of you in Twitch chat? Is there anything that... Well, I haven't shown the second combo. I'll do that on creeps. And, well, if I don't mind, I have too much damage to do it on creeps, but... We'll see. Bam, bam, bam. Yeah, my team killed me by proccing Nomad ult. Shit happens. What Nomad skin is that? I think it's the new one. Not sure what it's called exactly, but... He just said bitch again on YouTube? Come on. I'm sorry for cursing. I'm sorry. You can't upload this game, you fed hard. In the end, my educationals are all about teaching players how to become better at the hero, and I think that I've played well this game in terms of the hero, how it is. I've just been caught. Like, Bloodhunter spells have... Like, I don't really think this is a bad educational. I could do another game if you want. If you guys don't think this educational is good enough, I can do another one. Like, that's fine by me. Oh my fucking god. I swear to god, man. The only frustrating thing here is that every time I respawn, there are four heroes where I am. God damn. Can I repeat the two combos? I can, in a second. He's dead. Thanks, Mickey, man. Educational is about swearing. Alright, we really need to finish that Shrunken, man. Shrunken is so vital in this game. One of your structures is under attack. I'm joking, please no more Monkey King. La-di-da-di-da. We're so close. Look at that team, why do you buy Shroud? Because it's good. It allowed me to get a pickoff. It allows me to escape whenever I'm a Bloodhunter ulted. Or Bloodhunter spotted. Should be a kill here, right? Yes, Chief still. Nice kill. Good kill, guys. No Storm versus a Bloodhunter is like asking to lose. Well, the thing is that there's five heroes on a team. If Bloodhunter ultis me, that means that I'll be like, as long as I have a Shrunken, I'll be totally fine. So if he ultis me, it doesn't really matter in the end. Like, my team will just destroy them after that. So I personally don't think it matters. Also, I'm not a fan of Nullstun and Monkey King at all. And even if I did buy a Nullstone this game, they still have 10 other spells I can remove my Nullstone, so I don't even think that I'll be able to remove Bloodhunter ulti.
Find Mummy.
Here's a plan, record Mickey and Monkey King, and then record it. Uh-huh. The new hero has a sheep. Yes, he does. On three successful auto attacks, it, they basically get sheeped. If your combo is on cooldown, which spell is the most damage? When you have as much damage as I do, my Q deals the most damage, because obviously it deals your attack damage. And right now I have 231, so that's 400. 460 plus the initial 30, so that's 520. So I do 520 damage with my Q right now.
I'm not there.
Nemesis. I actually survived that.
Crap. Oh crap. Armor assimilated. They're all coming. I'll see if I can catch him. Fucking god. Can we go, Cloud? Do you have anything?
They have nothing left, like no B.O. I mean, Bernardo.
I don't have my ultimate.
Wait, I have combos in.
Piece of cake. Too easy. Waste of time. No chance.
Good stuff. I have 20 assists, man. What is this? So what I want to finish next is most likely a Jinjuro here, and then after that we can go another item, but I think Jinjuro is pretty good to finish here. Will give me that extra slow that I need for chasing down heroes, and also give me a lot of damage, of course. Can we get an Abyssal New Solstice? Would be very nice.
Powerhorn destroyed a Legion tower.
Oh my god, I'm so
Well, people forget Among King as well, so you can auto-attack. People tend to only use their spells like him. Yeah, indeed. People do forget to auto-attack a lot of Among King. Because he does tons and tons of damage, yeah, especially with your Q. Like, your Q is like... Oh, shit. I mean, your Q is... Oh, right, they increased the... 3.3k or 3.2. God damn it, I forgot about that. Like your Q plus auto attacks is so much damage. I mean, right now I can deal 750 damage just by one auto attack and two Qs. Obviously, non negated with armor, but still, like a lot. I'm kind of greedy, bruh. Alright, sending out that Jinjuro. Okay, we got it picked up. Slapped, I sent you a whisper. Where? No see. Me no see it. Oh, they have an eye. Can we just initiate and kill the hag? With sheep and stuff? Or go for...
No matter what. Oh, she's gonna reward me.
No, I think you can just go in on the hag. We sheep him and then I kill him. I can just shrunken up and kill him. Nope. Here. Cause he has the shroud, right? Oh, here we go.
Here's an eye. Oh! Get them both.
Five kills done! That fucking multicast, though.
Massacre!
Alright. Can you catch him, Top? Alright. Try to. I am running, just keep chasing.
I'm keeping.
Might be able to catch a Nomad here.
Not in place.
I amazed myself.
Damn it! How to sell items when you are far from well? Control shift right click on your item.
Ah, this is a range.
So we're 550 GPM. Next item we would pick up here would be a Wingbow, probably. Yeah, for sure a Wingbow. That will help us a lot against those three heroes they have. And they don't really have a sheep yet, so they can't kill me during the Wingbow. Wingbow would definitely be my next item. I can kill that, bro.
The Hellborn have destroyed a Legion tower.
Careful, don't dive.
A Legion Barracks has been destroyed. A Legion Barracks has been destroyed.
Right, so push out mid, can go Conger after that. 22 assists, can't believe I'm failing kill stealing. Who am I if not a kill stealer? I don't even know who I am anymore.
I'm gonna get the bishop.
Yep.
One of your structures is under attack.
Will you come when I have it?
Yep.
On the way.
Alright, halfway towards Wingbow as well, so we're getting really, really farmed here. Not that it matters. We are 4v5, of course, but yeah. I've died so many times this game. I don't know, I feel kind of stupid. I think I should have gotten the bait after a while. So yeah, we're 316 damage right now, which is of course insane. That's 900 damage with Q and one auto attack before armor reduction, of course. But that's a lot of damage right now. We can still, of course, kill any hero in the game with Hellflower. And let's see if we can catch this blacksmith. I'll go up kill Pearl instead. Go calm. Go. Alright, let's pick up token here.
Yeah, apply all my stupid stuff to Kongo, right?
Hmm? Hex and you can hex it, you can hex Kong, yes.
Yeah, I can also do something.
Oh my god, that hero!
It's a very good hero.
A very repeat hero, yes.
Kongor has been slain!
Alright, Wingbow and 500.
Attack this structure.
Yes, it has a lot of things. Alright, sending out my Wingbow. There we go. They shouldn't really be able to kill me now without using like spells. Like, things gonna be very, very hard for them. But we'll find out.
One of your structures is under attack.
Where's my Abyssal? I can't lifesteal without Abyssal, man.
The Hellborn have destroyed a Legion tower.
Okay, there we go, Wingbow. Or as people call it nowadays, Wingbow.
A Legion barrack.
Oh shit, I'm into
my knight!
Doom.
Got him, team.
Oh god.
Yeah, that was kind of deep, bro.
I almost get Bloodhound on the 4v1. That's quite insane.
Yeah. A Legion barracks has been destroyed.
How didn't the Abyssal work? Oh my god.
Serial killer.
Well, that didn't really do anything. Nemesis. They're goddamn Void Talismans. So I think I would finish this game off with a Harkons just to counter their Void Talismans. I think they had three of them. Anyway, we do end up on 630 GPM. I hope you guys enjoyed this Monkey King educational video. Don't forget to subscribe and leave a like on the video if you liked it. And yeah, I think I'll see you guys in the next one.